From 1940 to 1966, the US invested at least $10.1 trillion in today's dollars in nuclear weapons development, producing over 70,000 nuclear warheads
since 1945,
surpassing the combined total of all other nuclear-armed nations. However, since the Cold War ended, the American nuclear arsenal has been reduced by 85%, and younger generations now encounter fallout shelters only in dystopian video games. Although not as prominent as during the Cold War, the threat of nuclear attack has never entirely disappeared. Russia and China are both enhancing the capability and quantity of their ICBMs. Even North Korea has expanded its arsenal, which was estimated to be around 10 to 20 nuclear warheads in 2018. Additionally, India and Pakistan each possess over 100 nuclear warheads. The United States stresses the importance of maintaining a nuclear force that effectively deters adversaries, reassures allies and partners, fulfills US objectives if deterrence fails, and safeguards against uncertain threats. This is where the United States Nuclear Triad enters the stage. The United States Nuclear Triad is a cornerstone of its national defense strategy, representing the capability to deliver nuclear weapons from land-based missiles, submarine-launched missiles, and strategic bombers. This tripartite system was developed during the Cold War to ensure a robust and survivable nuclear deterrent against any adversary, particularly the Soviet Union. The land-based intercontinental ballistic missile, or ICBM, component of the United States Nuclear Triad is a critical element of the nation's strategic deterrence posture. Before we move on to its details, let us briefly explain what an ICBM is and how it operates. As a definition, any supersonic missile that has a range of at least 4,040 miles and follows a ballistic trajectory after a powered guided launch falls into the ICBM category. At takeoff, the ICBM enters the boost phase until it reaches space. In the second phase, the ICBM enters space as it continues on its ballistic trajectory. In the third phase, on the way back down to the ground, it ejects a number of independently targetable re-entry vehicles and decoys. Those vehicles are nuclear warheads. You will know what happens next. One of the primary advantages of ICBMs is their ability to be launched quickly. The high alert status and rapid response time ensures that the US can retaliate swiftly in the event of a nuclear attack. This immediacy serves as a strong deterrent, signaling to adversaries that any nuclear aggression will be met with a prompt and devastating response. The development of ICBMs dates back to the early Cold War era, driven by the need for a credible deterrent against the Soviet Union. Atlas, Titan, Minuteman, and Peacekeeper, as the land-based ICBM missiles that have maintained America's nuclear deterrent since the early 1960s. In the 1960s, the Minuteman series revolutionized ICBM technology. The Minuteman I was the first solid-fueled ICBM, offering greater readiness and simpler maintenance compared to its liquid-fueled predecessors. The subsequent Minuteman II and Minuteman III variants incorporated advancements in guidance systems, payload capacity, and warhead design, making them more effective and reliable. US ICBMs are spread out in 400 hardened underground silos. In addition to this, there are another 50 silos kept in warm status. These are assigned to separate military bases, presenting an intractable targeting problem for any potential adversary. Each missile is kept in a state of high readiness, capable of being launched within minutes of receiving a launch order. Minuteman III missiles utilize an advanced inertial guidance system, which allows them to strike targets with high precision. The guidance system continuously calculates the missile's position, velocity, and trajectory, ensuring it remains on course throughout its flight. ICBMs also provide the ability to upload additional warheads, which can hedge against technical failure in one of the other legs of the triad, or respond to adverse geopolitical developments. Although the ICBMs can carry up to 3 nuclear warheads, each is currently loaded with only 1. This provides targeting flexibility, especially for some scenarios of an adversary's limited use. The Minuteman III missiles, first developed in the 1970s, are now several decades old. Despite numerous upgrades and life extension programs, the aging infrastructure represents challenges in terms of reliability and maintenance. The need for a modern replacement has become increasingly urgent. To address these challenges and ensure the continued effectiveness of the ICBM force, the US has embarked on the Ground-Based Strategic Deterrent, or GBSD, program. This program aims to replace the Minuteman III missiles with a new generation of ICBMs, designated as LGM-35 Sentinel, featuring advanced technology and enhanced survivability. LGM-35 Sentinel missiles will incorporate advanced countermeasures to evade missile defenses and improve their ability to survive a first strike. These missiles will boast upgraded guidance systems and propulsion technology that will enhance their accuracy and reliability. The Air Force has requested a new design for ICBM launch facilities, as the original silo designs are deemed unsuitable for modern warfare. The first GBSD missiles are expected to enter service in the early 2030s, with full deployment planned by the mid-2030s. This timeline ensures a seamless transition from Minuteman III to the new system, maintaining a continuity of the US land-based deterrent. A significant vulnerability of ICBMs is their fixed locations, which can be identified and targeted by adversaries. While the silos are heavily fortified, a determined and sophisticated attack could potentially compromise them. This is where the second component of the nuclear triad steps in. The second leg of the triad consists of ballistic missile submarines, or SSBMs, currently represented by the Ohio-class submarines. These submarines patrol the world's oceans, providing a stealthy and virtually undetectable platform for nuclear launch. The mobility and concealment of SSBMs make them a highly survivable element of the triad, capable of ensuring a retaliatory strike even after a significant portion of the US nuclear arsenal has been neutralized. The Ohio-class submarines are being replaced by the Columbia-class submarines, which are expected to enter service in the early 2030s, ensuring the viability of the sea-based deterrent for decades to come. The Trident D-5, also known as the Trident II, is a ballistic missile launched from a submarine. The United States and the United Kingdom have deployed these missiles. Trident II missiles from the United States are carried by Ohio-class submarines, while British missiles are carried by Vanguard-class submarines. The range of the Trident II missiles is 4,847 miles at full load and 7,456 miles at reduced load. Each US Trident II missile can carry up to 14.475 kiloton warheads. The Trident II missile is extremely accurate. The astro-inertial navigation system guides it to the target, but it can also receive GPS updates. The fact that it is submarine-launched makes it more effective, as US ballistic missile submarines are extremely hard to detect. The third component used to include long-range bombers such as the B-52 Stratofortress, B-1 Lancer. Nuclear capability has been removed from the B-1B, and the B-52 no longer carries gravity nuclear bombs. For the time being, the strategic bomber component of the nuclear triad includes only B-2 Spirit and the upcoming B-21 stealth bombers. These aircraft can deliver both nuclear and conventional weapons and can be launched on short notice. Unlike ICBMs and SLBMs, bombers can be recalled after takeoff, providing a unique element of flexibility and control in a nuclear crisis. Additionally, strategic bombers can serve as a visible deterrent through strategic patrols and exercises, signaling US resolve and readiness. The upcoming B-21 Raider will further enhance this leg of the triad with advanced stealth capabilities and improved survivability against modern air defenses. The strategic bomber component of the US nuclear triad features a range of bombs and missiles designed for nuclear payload delivery, ensuring effective deterrence and strike capabilities. Key nuclear bombs include the versatile B-61, with variants ranging from B-61-3 to the modernized B-61-12, capable of different yields for tactical and strategic roles. The high-yield B-83 bomb reaches up to 1.2 megatons. Air-launched missiles include the AGM-86 Air-Launched Cruise Missile, or ALCM, particularly the AGM-86B variant, with a range of over 1,500 miles, designed to penetrate enemy defenses. Future developments focus on the long-range standoff, or LRSO, missile, set to replace the AGM-86B. The LRSO will feature enhanced stealth, range, and survivability, and will be deployed on the upcoming B-21 Raider, ensuring continued strategic bomber effectiveness in modern and future threat environments. This concludes our episode that provides a glimpse into the nuclear triad of the US. There are, of course, many other remarkable concepts in the US military. So what do you think about this nuclear deterrent? Do you think it's still effective? Also, if you were lucky enough to see one of the weapon systems mentioned in this video up close, or better yet, operated or maintained one, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.